Today, we're going to be shooting the S-Lizard from Sniper Sling. Don't go away. .5 millimeter clay. Let's get it. Oh, no way. All right, guys. So we got a new VIP, and I've got a new 2.5 centimeter flipper in that catch box. And I owe somebody a bullseye. Mark Townsend, that one's for you, buddy. Thanks for the support, my friend. Oh man, we just broke a squirrel ball. Today we're gonna be shooting the S-Lizard from Sniper Sling. I've had this guy for quite some time, but now it's time to do the review on it. And by the way, squirrel ball, it's okay. Just hit so damn violently, it scoops something up out of the tray and threw it onto the floor. So there it is. Let's get to it. Anybody else's dog eat dirt? Well, the overall shooting experience of this frame is actually pretty nice. It holds pretty well. It'll take a decent sized band. And the good thing about the handmade slingshots from Sniper Sling is you can have them tweaked to fit your hand as you want. So you can ask for a little longer, a little shorter, wider forks, narrower forks. It all works out pretty nice. Today, I've got these set up with some Sniper Sling 0.4 tapered from 22 to 14 with a 9.5 millimeter pouch, but we're shooting 8 mil steel. Now, why am I doing this? Because we are going to be flipping back and forth today with 8mm steel and clay. Let's take one more shot and get into the specs. There we go. Now, the overall length of this guy is 130 millimeters. I got it a little extra long because I got a big old mitt. This is a chunky little S-Lizard right here, coming in at 20 millimeters at the bottom and 15 millimeters at the top. I like to shoot off the fork tips, so I got a 90 millimeter fork width, which shoots point on for me. The S-Lizard comes with a very secure 23 millimeter clipped two screw fork tips that'll hold on to any kind of band you want to put on here. It's got some decent weight to it. It's coming in at 167.65 grams, and that's with a lanyard and bead and a band set. Let's get those 40s. Ooh, barely got that one. All right, we painted the last one orange because my white bands would disappear in them. Yep. See if we can get that squirrel ball. There it is, got it in two. This is another well-designed slingshot from Sniper Sling. When I ordered it, I got the handle to be a little bit longer. I think I asked for a centimeter longer. I probably could have gone with a half centimeter. You see, your hand gets put up really close to the forks. I still have a little bit of extra here, which would have been fine if I only had a half centimeter. It would have cut down on the size and weight of the slingshot, which I don't know if it would be a benefit or not, but either way, it still holds pretty well. You've got the junk in the trunk down here, forcing your hand towards the forks, which is where you want it. It's a great for a pinch, for a brace grip. I don't know if I'd pinch grip it. It feels a little bit too much of a stretch for my hand, but somebody with longer fingers or an extra large hand will be just fine. I wear a large to extra large glove, but somebody with longer fingers may be okay. Now, the forks are nice and short the way I like them. They line up really, really nice and holds really well. So all in all, this is a great holding slingshot. We're gonna head on down to the line, take a couple of shots. I don't think I'll be doing a pinch grip with this today just because of the shape of it. I don't think it'll work well for me. I can't seem to get a good grip, but we'll take a couple of shots with it in a brace, and we'll do the usual. Take a shot and I'll play it back in slow motion. You can see if there's any movement. Then we'll talk about the comfort. All right, so I'm gonna get this guy in a good brace grip. We're going to take a shot at that green 40 mil wasp flipper right down the center there, and have a look at my thumb, see if anything moves around while I take my shot. That looked like it stayed right where it belongs to me. Here we go. Let's check it out in the slow-mo. Let's try a really good close-up. See that? It's a great grip. So we got the battle tree set up right here. We're gonna go ahead and take a few shots, starting from the bottom, work our way up to the top. I have switched to clays, so I'm gonna be far less accurate than I am normally, but let's see how it goes. Yep. Yeah, I've found a lot of these clays, the quality is pretty crap. The sizes are all different. They fly, sometimes they look like knuckleballs. It's crazy. There's the bottom. Ooh, and we got it to stay over there too. That's good. Usually they bounce back if it's not perfectly level. There's two. There's three. Oh, just wide. There's four. There's five. Oh, we got one to stay. That's two. And there's six. Not bad. I thought it was gonna be much worse than that. Let's finish off this talk about the grip. Overall, I give it probably around a 7/10. The reason why I give it a 7/10 is only because of this. Have a look at the profile. See how it's kind of rounded in here? On the front end, when you're holding it with your finger, everything feels fantastic. But I wouldn't have minded a little bit more rounding on the corners here where your fingers kind of hold on to the frame. I just find I get like a, I feel like something's poking me in my hand here. It could be a little bit more rounded off, but besides that, still very comfortable, extremely, extremely stable grip. Really can't go wrong with this. So 7/10, still a pretty damn good score. So would I consider this a good EDC frame? Yeah, I would. It's got a few things going for it, but it is around, probably around the maximum that I would carry in thickness as an EDC frame. That's 2 centimeters, is a little bit on the chunky side. So if you're trying to slide this in and out of a pocket, it may be tough if you're wearing some tight fitting clothes, but for like sport shorts, like I'm wearing right now, something you'd wear going jogging or whatever it is, it slides in and out of the pocket. So that's really easy. You'll see a clip of it right up here. But the smooth texture of it and the design of the handle makes it hold good. It's a good shooter. It'll slide in and out of pockets easy enough. It's got a little bit of weight to it, which is not bad. It gives you a good stable shot. And overall, it would be a pretty damn good EDC frame. So I would give that somewhere around a 7 or an 8 on 10 as an EDC frame. So that's a pretty damn good thumbs up on that. Not bad. So now that we're done shooting with the Sniper Sling S Lizard, what can we say about this bad boy? Well, basically, you got a very capable slingshot for precision shooting all the way down to planking. It's a pretty decent EDC frame. It'll fit most pockets, not a problem. And the grip of it's fantastic. That said, the only thing I could really complain about, and I'm going to turn this camera around real quick and show you, and it's kind of weird because I've sang the praises of the fit and finish on Sniper Sling's slingshots many, many times. But I'll show you. I'll take a look at this. And there is one tiny little flaw. All right, guys. Have a look. So let's see if you can catch it. So far, absolute perfection. The G10, the resin, everything. Just perfect. No transitions, no nothing. All the pins, everything looks fantastic. No complaints at all. All right, did you catch it? Bet you can see it now. Yeah, right up here, there was a little bubble in the resin that they didn't fill up. I was a little bit disappointed when I saw that because you're kind of expecting to have a perfect frame. I didn't send it back only because there's been so many perfect slingshots that I've received from them, and really this is not going to affect how it shoots in any stretch, way, or form. And to be honest, when I'm holding it, my finger covers the hole, so I don't really care. But that's the only complaint I have about this slingshot and every single Sniper slingshot I've ever owned, to be honest. I don't want you to assume that your slingshot's going to come with a defect like this in it. Really, it's something very, very small, and I've sang the praises of Sniper Sling over and over and over again for their fit and finish and their quality of work. I don't know how this happened or why it happened or how it arrived to me. I'd be very shocked that they let something pass quality control that was like that and didn't try to repair it first. That said, when it arrived, I really didn't care too much. I mean, it's a small little thing, but I mean, this is the slingshot that I bought, and this is the one I have to review. So I'm going to give you a good, honest review of every time, regardless of who it's from. So there we go. The S Lizard. Let's get down to business. So this thing, in my opinion, is a fantastic shooter for the precision shooter, for the plinker, for the hunter, for anything you really need to do. It'll just keep on bringing it. It's a good holding slingshot. It's a pretty decent EDC slingshot. You slide this in and out of any pocket, carry it in purse, pouch, pocket, or bag, or anything you want to carry it in. Not a problem. It holds real well. I know I mentioned that already. We've done some really damn good shooting with it today. That opening shot on that clay, I couldn't believe I actually landed that in my first shot, which is pretty nuts. But we've done pretty good precision shooting with this thing today, and we're switching back and forth between clays and steel. And we got that 0.4 Sniper Sling, which is performing fantastic in this kind of heat. So this is the win, guys. If you guys are looking for one for a slingshot, that you want to get one from Sniper Sling, this might be the way to go. And they do actually have a really nice wooden model that's out now that I'll probably want to get my hands on one of these days. Anyway, I'm going to wrap this one up. You guys stay safe, get out and practice, be good to each other. I'll see you again soon. I love you guys, you're freaking awesome. Bye for now. Hey, thanks for watching, guys. If you like this video, hit that thumbs up button for me and subscribe if you haven't already. On this end screen here, I'm going to attach a couple of videos I've done on Sniper Sling slingshots for you to check out. I think you'll enjoy these ones too. Just like all the other Sniper Sling handmade slingshots I reviewed, the S Lizard is no different. It's just another well thought out, well designed slingshot, and it was an absolute pleasure to shoot. So alright guys, hopefully you enjoyed the video, and if you did, I'd like you to consider becoming a member to the channel, and also, check down in the description below, there's also a new link to my store. Ooh, I've got some merch for sale, guys. Hope you guys are interested. Alright, take care. You guys stay safe, shoot straight. I'll talk to you soon. Bye for now.